west side of Bern, we have a major tornado coming down.
Oh my God!
May 20th, 2013. One of the worst tornadoes on record was captured in a time-lapse video that went viral.
Here it is, Damon.
Large tornado.
We have large debris in the air. Here it is, Damon, right in front of me. People in Westmore need to be underground on this tornado. We have debris, large chunks of debris.
The entire nation watched as the storm took a direct hit on Plaza Towers Elementary School in Moore, Oklahoma, claiming the lives of 7 children.
By the time I got to the school, I still hadn't heard any word on Kyle. And from the looks of the school, I knew it wasn't looking good.
Winds recorded at over 210 miles per hour ripped through the school, knocking down walls and turning the playground into a pile of rubble.
I think if you live in Tornado Alley, it needs to be a priority. You need to have a shelter.
300 miles from Moore, in a lab in Texas Tech University, engineers worked to make Mickey Davis's goal for storm shelters a reality.
What we have here is it's an air cannon. It's called Boomer. Virtual potato launcher on steroids.
So you launch things straight at walls, is that
That's
what
right.
you do here?
Yeah.
Professor Larry Tanner does research on the effects of extreme winds and destruction caused by flying debris.
Pictures I've seen of the damage after a tornado is all about impact.
Where wind really becomes an issue is that the debris opens up the building envelope, the walls, the roof. Once you have that envelope opened, now you've got double the trouble. The most predominant projectile that we see in these storms is normally something like a 2x4.
So what you tend to see coming out of this cannon is what you tend to see flying around when a tornado is spinning.
Absolutely. We did shelter research for the National Science Foundation back in May after the Moore tornado, specifically just to look for shelters in the storm path.
The question now is not whether to rebuild, but how.
We're smart engineers. We know how to design for the wind speeds. And now we know how to design for impact resistance.
Researchers performed tests on a variety of building materials. Some of them failed. Through trial and error, innovation came in the form of reinforcement and engineering.
So should we
load the
cannon?
Load the cannon. Okay, let's do it.
Wow.
103 miles an hour.
103? It's completely fine.
This particular wall is what we call a double white brick. In other words, you've got one wall of brick here, another wall of brick here, and then there's a 4-inch cavity that's filled with concrete and reinforcing steel. This wall will totally resist the EF-5 missile.
But this shows that you can have a safe place above ground.
The beautiful thing about an above ground shelter is that it's a dual use space.
So is that what you would advise a school like Plaza Towers?
Absolutely.
In the heart of Tornado Alley in Oklahoma City, Oakdale Elementary was hit twice.
So we're relying on that testing that's done at Texas Tech to tell us what kind of construction will withstand those projectiles.
Jeff Wegner and John Joyce design Oakdale's new safe room.
We just adapt those standards and build to those.
It has to support the load, not only of the roof, but also the pressure for a 250 mile per hour wind for an EF5 tornado.
These walls are really thick. They were thickened to become a safe room.
And these are
12 inches thick.
Another real important thing in a safe room is the connections, where the wall and the roof intersect. We have to do all these special connections because obviously you don't want that coming apart and the roof comes off and then the wall can fail and all these kind of terrible things that can happen.
So is that where the innovation lies?
It's two things. It's the forces pulling the building apart and it's keeping projectiles from coming through the walls. Kim said, I want just a structure that we can be confident that it's not gonna fall in on these kids.
How do you feel about having this?
I feel like we have a safer place to come than we did before. And in those times where we may have to have a safer place to bring our students, we have it.
And that's the hope for schools like Oakdale and Plaza Towers, that by using innovative building techniques, they can keep their children and communities safe.
Thank you very much.
Oh, my goodness.
It's coming down right now. Major tornado.
Coming down. Another tornado.
Deadly tornado rushes toward the U.S. community of Oklahoma City. The two-mile-wide wind tunnel ripped through the state capitol on Monday.
Oh, my God!
That was the tragedy on the ground, but new innovations are being developed in the lab to protect against future disasters.
We create tornado-like vortices. We create things that mimic the characteristics of tornado wind speed.
I'm at the National Wind Institute at Texas Tech University, where they can actually recreate tornadoes.
Darryl James, professor of mechanical engineering, designed and built a tornado simulator called Vortec.
A simulator like this allows us to repeatedly reproduce in a controlled fashion and try to understand what happens to the structures.
Tornado winds are rated on an EF scale, which is an indicator of the severity of a storm based on wind speed and debris impact.
So this was designed to do mid-EF3, so on the scaling means about 150 miles per hour or less.
Have you ever stood in the vortex?
Oh, absolutely, all the time. Would you like to go?
This is the bit I've been waiting for.
I'll turn it on slow.
Yeah.
And then
build it up.
Build it up.
Okay, so you're gonna leave me here on my own.
You're good.
At this point, I was wondering just how powerful an EF3 would be. Just about imagine how terrifying a tornado can be.
Through your research, you're hoping to be able to recommend how to reinforce building codes.
That's correct. What we really want to do is be able to recommend building codes and practices that people should consider when building in areas that are prone to tornadoes.
We have no way of knowing how severe a tornado can be. We heard that it was on the ground. It looked like it was going to be a bad one.
Jimmy Fleming, public information officer for Moore Public Schools.
Meteorologists that we have are doing a great job of being on the cutting edge on the technology that lets us predict the storms.
In the reconstruction of Plaza Towers, how much innovation is being implemented to ensure safety?
The main thing is the actual storm shelter itself. These particular storm shelter walls are solid concrete, still reinforced into the foundation, in through the ceiling. If a tornado were to hit the building, the shelter's gonna stand.
Do you think this is gonna save lives?
I hope we never find out.
Mickey Davis is the mother of Kyle Davis, one of the seven children who lost their lives at Plaza Towers.
It was just something I've never experienced. We got around to the school, and it was very hard to look at the school that day, because I had just taken, I had just taken them to school. And the school didn't look like what it did when I dropped them off on Friday. There were seven families searching for kids. I didn't find out until the next morning. It was 18 hours later.
So Mickey, it's very soon after May 20th. So what do you want to do next?
I want a shelter in every school. My goal is to protect every child in Oklahoma, not just Moore.
Do you think you will achieve shelters in schools?
Some days, you know, are harder to get up and fight for it, but Kyle wouldn't want that.
We need shelters in every Oklahoma school.
Kyle would want me to get up and fight and do all that I possibly can so that kids are protected in the future.
We can't prevent tornadoes from hitting the ground, but innovations are helping us predict their movement and protect against their impact. In a town like Moore, the technologies combined with the resilience of the community will help them rebuild.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.